Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello. This is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International, bringing you matters of faith with Graphic Online. I'd like to capture my thoughts this morning with the words, deadly delay. I'm feeling the Numbers chapter 12 story of Aaron, Miriam, and Moses. God said to Aaron, Miriam, and Moses, now separate yourself and come closer to me. I want to deal with this situation. And immediately God struck, by the time God finished talking with them, Miriam was a leper. And here's the interesting thing. When Miriam became a leper, and then Moses went pleading, and Moses was telling God, look here, you can't do this, you need to, then Moses, and God said, get out of my way. It is my right to bring discipline to my child. And you know, that's sometimes what happens to us. Maybe sometimes a child has done something, the father is bringing discipline, the mother then steps in and says, no, you can't do that. Or, The mother is bringing discipline, and the father steps in and says, no, you don't do that. God said to Moses, get out of my way. I'm dealing with my daughter. And as a result of that, God then tells Moses, let her stay outside the camp and let the whole of Israel wait for her to get better before they move on. Miriam's foolishness and Miriam's intransigence and Miriam's jealousy or Miriam's cantankerousness, or Miriam's cantankerous nature, or Miriam's quarrelsome, or Miriam's, over challenge, rebellion, the challenge of authority, it costs the people of Israel dearly. So, the attraction to the promised land, or their walk to the promised land, part of the delay was Miriam. Because of Miriam's, the whole of Israel got delayed. Is it possible that your family might be receiving a blessing, or your family might be walking into a blessing, but because of you, there's going to be delay? Or is it possible that sometimes your church, and because of you, because you occupy a position of authority in the house of God, or because you occupy a position of authority in the company, and because of your rebellious nature, or because of your intransigence, or because of your cantankerous, quarrelsome nature, or because of argumentative abilities and attitudes and all those things, and your displeasure with authority, and the way you rebel, and you don't only rebel within you, you also communicate that rebellion to other people, so that other people becomes passengers in your bus of rebellion. Is it possible that sometimes growth, expansion, success, progress is stunted because of you? Because of you. Because of your lack of submission, or because of your lack of obedience, because in your heart as a leader, as a person in a position of prominence, that was what Miriam was. Miriam was in a position of a place of prominence. Miriam and Aaron formed the executive committee of Moses. But because of Miriam's attitude, the people of Israel were delayed. Is it possible that sometimes because of you, progress in the company, progress in the church, progress in the family is halted until God can get you straight, until God can get you fixed up, until God can straighten you out? How sad it is that sometimes we forget that God places us around leadership. We are associates. We are not the vision. We are helpers to the vision. So sometimes we confuse, our association. We confuse our association. And we think that we are the aim. We are the goal. We are not the goal. And it is very sad. The people of God, companies, and it's going to pay a price because of your attitude and because of the things that you fellowship around. Deadly belief is a choice you made. See you later.